So what's up, guys? Welcome to the new Statistician YouTube channel, and today we're going to be talking to you guys about box plots. So what do box plots kind of go? Five number summary, some different types of box plots, and how to use it when in an actual data analysis situation. So what exactly do box plots tend to show? Well, in really most basic terms, box plot really just shows us the five number summary. And that's basically just the minimum quartile, which is the 25th percentile, the median, which is also the 50th percentile of a data distribution, the third quartile, which is the 75th percentile, and of course the maximum. It's really useful when you want to look at the distribution of your data. So you have really just, you're thinking about one random variable or one variable, sort of one column of your data set. And you want to really analyze that one, see what's that one sort of saying. Another word really quickly about box that are common for box plots is just the box and whisker plot. And in brief, really, the box plot gives us a simple visualization for your numeric data. And of course, there are simple types. There are really quite a few different types of box plots. The most basic is obviously that single box plot that you guys see here. Kind of a bit boring, we admit, but it does present the five number summary really easily for us to see. It is also possible to make the box plot a bit more interesting rather than just keep. You can have what we call sort of like an overlaid box plot where you have sort of multiple categories. Say this is from the IRIS, the famous IRIS dataset, which is linked below. You can access it down below at our website. And so we can kind of see here we have the three flower categories and their sepal link overlaid with sort of how the actual number values appear. Sort of makes your analysis a little bit more robust, a little bit more interesting. The key thing about sort of overlaid box plots that it sort of gives us is sort of gives us an idea of where clustering tends to happen. So in this case, the data is pretty uniform, so there's not a whole lot of clustering that can be identified in this case. Let's go to our next example to sort of see it a little bit better. Here, this is from our Pima Indian dataset, also linked below. And we can kind of see just a little bit of clustering going on sort of at the higher BMIs. So this is the BMI risk factor outcome is, of course, diabetes, one being yes, two being no. And you can kind of see a little bit of clustering here. So this is sort of some of the things that overlaid box plots can sort of help you with. A histogram or a scatter plot can always do better, but if you're looking at just one variable directly, then box plot is not a bad thing if you especially want to understand where those minimum and maximum lie or where those percentiles lie. We'll have another video on percentiles. And so let's get down to the bottom line. This is sort of the key point takeaway from the video. Box plots basically let us look at the spread of a numeric variable. Aside from a histogram that shows sort of the actual distribution, box plots gives us sort of that spread in terms of just really five numbers. So it's a little easier to process for us, like we mentioned. And then it also allows us sort of to compare levels of numeric variables by categorical variable. So as we saw before, in those overlaid box plots, we can actually plot more than one category. And of course, it also gives us a slight look at the clustering in our data, similar to how histograms and scatter plots can help us, but not really as well. And so that's really all we have for you in this really short video on box plots. If you guys like some of the content that we've been sort of dishing out on YouTube, be sure to give us a like, thumbs up, and subscribe. We also have a Patreon link below. Thanks for watching. Happy mining.